Hello everyone, and welcome to this live presentation for Balluff's automation launch. My name is Chris Duncan. I'm the trade show and event specialist for Balluff, and I will be your host for today's presentation. I'd like to take a moment to remind everybody to please explore the automation launch virtual trade show platform and check out all the different exhibits that we have and gain the knowledge that will help you be prepared for 2021. We will also have Balluff staff on hand throughout the week, so please connect with them using the chat feature. Before we get going, I just have a couple of housekeeping items to enhance your experience. So for the best viewing experience, please close any additional browser sessions or web browser tabs or any other applications or programs that are running in the background. This will help with your bandwidth. Streaming live video presentations is bandwidth intensive, so this will help conserve your bandwidth. Also, if you have a question, please use the Q&A chat box to ask any questions that you may have for our presenter. And after he's finished with his presentation, I will gather those throughout the presentation, and afterwards we will ask our presenter to answer those questions for you. If you're viewing this presentation in the future, you're not with us live, please use the contact me after this event button in the virtual exhibition, exhibitions in the on the virtual platform, and we will be able to respond to your question via email. The presentation slides can be found in the Q&A chat. I listed a link there to a box.com folder that has the presentation slides for today if you'd like to follow along with that. And a replay of this presentation will be available after the presentation ends using the same button that you used through the platform to be able to access it. Our presenter today is Frank Jakubec. He is our sales specialist and product manager for Matrix Vision, a brand of Balluff. And Frank is has more than 10 years of experience with B2B product and solution selling. He is an experienced sales leader and is skilled in business development. Frank has presented on machine vision and industrial cameras in trade publications like Control Design. After the acquisition of Matrix Vision by Balluff in 2017, he took the opportunity to move to the United States from the Czech Republic and to establish the machine vision product portfolio and grow the machine vision market in the United States. And without further ado, I'd like to present Frank Jakubec with Get a New Perspective on Vision Cameras.
Hello, Chris, and welcome everybody. Chris, I just want to check that you can hear me very well.
Yes, Frank, I can hear you loud and clear.
Perfect, great, thank you. Thank you for your introduction and great spelling of my name. You made it really great job. And feel free to call me Frank, because for lots of people, it's very difficult to pronounce my name. So Frank is really, really great with me. So today I will present you information about how to get a new perspective on vision cameras, or subtitle can be also empower your equipment and machine vision system with a more intelligent industrial camera. So let's start it. So agenda. I divided for six blocks, and I will start very generally. What is a machine vision? I want to get us all of us on the same level that we know, and we are discussing how and what we expect from machine vision. And I will discuss in more details what is different and what is image processing and pre-processing approach or brain. Another chapter will be what is image sensor and what is important to know. There are two basic technologies, CCD and CMOS, and I will tell you more about it. Number three, it will be what made the industrial camera more intelligent. Next chapter will be about functions and features which are inside of the industrial camera, and how to make it the camera more intelligent, how you can use it in your applications. And number five, don't adjust the whole system around the camera. You are able to modify the camera to your needs or to your image. And number six will be if the modification does not work to you and you are looking for really pure OEM or customized camera, you can be surprised that it can be even more easier than you expect. So let's begin. So first part will be really general about machine vision. So what is exactly different about image processing and pre-processing brain? And I will explain it very easily on the picture which is in front of you. So what is machine vision system in general? Very basic information. So you need some object which you need to analyze, you need to detect. In production, you want to check, for example, the quality. But it can be also, for example, in traffic applications, you are reading number plates. So you are looking for number plates. And in life science, for example, it can be blood samples, which you want to detect. So you need to have every time your object. Another part, which is very important, in 99% you will use the lighting. What is that? Of course, you need to make the best condition to observe your object. And there is many different type of lights. It can be ring lights, spotlights, backlights. But we could discuss here another half hour only about the lights, but this is not the object of this presentation. And so light really is very, very important. And also very important is lens. So there are again many different type of lenses. It can be telecentric, macro lenses, motorized liquid lenses, which you are able to connect with the camera. And you need to define your working distance, area of interest, the object size, and so on. So this is also another very, very important part of machine vision system. And then there are, I would say, two there is, let's say, cross-section which made two different approach, what you can use it, how camera can looks like. And first one is smart camera. What's that? It's actually all-in-one solution, which means that you have typically your image sensor, your PC, the lens, actually even lighting can be all-in-one, and you don't need any additional let's say system or another hardware which you need to detect the object. And second one is the industrial camera, which can be connected with vision controller, and this vision controller, which is typically industrial PC, and it includes also the smart software. So when you have a look on smart camera, you can see that this the vision controller is part of the smart camera, and because it's very, I would say, tiny PC, so typically vision controller is much powerful. It can be really even 30 times more powerful on software and analysis than the standard smart camera. And also a very different one is that with smart camera, you are typically limited with resolution. You can choose 2, 3, maybe 4 different type of resolution, but that's it. In industrial camera, you can take any resolution which is available, connect to your vision controller, and then it depends on power of your controller and your software, how fast you are able to analyze your object. So this is two basic explanation about smart camera and industrial camera with vision controller and software. So And what I want to discuss today about is what you can get it from image processing brain versus pre-processing brain. So I will start with image processing brain. And what's that? You will get it the picture, or let's say digital value, from your application to your image processing brain, which is the image library. And you are going to analyze the information which you get it by the software. And it depends on industry where you are, or object what you need to detect. It can be just simple measurement. It can be blob analysis, or very popular part of the software is OCV and OCR, what is optical character verification or recognition. It can be matching, but also, for example, deep learning, which is very, very popular right now, and it brings your applications to next level. So it really, there is many, many different options in the library which you can use, your camera and the software, and you are able to do it really whatever you want. So this is the part of image processing brain. So it means that you are processing image and analyzing what is on the image. But I will today discuss about this left part, which is pre-processing brain, which means that you can actually make it even better picture and better features, pre-processing features, before you will get the data and value to your image processing brain. Which means that the camera, what's that exactly? Camera includes the image sensor. So this is this part. An image sensor can be really different resolutions. It can be from 0.4 megapixel, it can be up to 31 megapixel cameras, it can be line scan image sensor or area scan sensor. So it depends really on application which you need to observe. But each image sensor includes or has pixels. And what these pixels are? So it's light sensitive cell which transfer electric value into a digital value. And when you are going to transfer this value, you can actually modify it already inside of the camera before it's going to your image processing brain. So as you probably recognize already today, I will not discuss about smart camera itself, where the PC or it's all in one solution. Today, I will more focus on industrial vision cameras, which can modify these pictures or information before it's going to image processing brain. And before I will go in details to these pre-processing features, what you can get it from the camera, I will get you something more about the technology of image sensor, because in these days you have still possibilities to define your sensor or camera on two different image sensors. It can be CCD or CMOS technology. And what you should use it? Actually, it's quite easy answer today, and I would like to recommend you to check your applications and functions and camera which you are going or you want to test it and use it. Please be sure that all of these cameras will have already CMOS sensor, image sensor, which is its shortcut for complementary metal oxide semiconductor. Actually, you will see still on the market also the version with CCD, which is a charge coupled device image sensor, but I would not recommend it at all to use it. As you can see it, from 2017, for example, Sony announced that they stopped producing it, these sensors, because the quality of CMOS sensors are coming much, much better. Yeah, it was long time when CCD had a better technical specification, like lower noise and better sensitivity to the light. But in these days, CMOS really catch all of these technical specifications where you really want to use actually the CMOS. And what's happened, or what was the reason that CCD was here really long time? Actually, it changed the technology which came to mobile phones, where CMOS is really start increasing the quality in development. And these phone cameras help actually to bring this technology also to industrial vision and cameras. So let's have a look how was it, for example, and I will show you how in last five years, it really changed. As you can see on the chart, here you see seven different image sensors and let's say cameras with different resolution. And in CCD world, there was not so many options. So you could choose faster cameras, but slow resolution, or high, let's say, much bigger resolution cameras, but the speed was very, very limited. And it started changing in 2013, when Sony introduced new sensors, CMOS. They are called IMX. It was first generation, and there was only two versions. They had very large pixel size, and there was some technical specification which were actually even, let's say, worse still than CCD. But there was another really great features, as for example speed, which helped to get it this technology on the world and to start using in many applications. And even it's already a long time when it was introduced, these two sensors are very well used these days. And what is great to know about it, that there is no information that these image sensors will be discontinued, which means that for vendors, it's great also that there will be available a really, really long time. Next and second generation of these sensors came in, it started coming in 2015, and this was really a huge generation. As you can see, there was many different options which you could choose for your applications and projects. So from 0.4 megapixels up to 31 megapixels. This is really great range of the sensors and cameras which we are able to provide actually. Third generation came as well. As you can see, the pixel size was a bit bigger, which means that also the whole size of the image sensors was also bigger. And you can see the biggest difference, for example, for C-mount lenses, which you are able to use it. In second generation, it was 12 megapixel compared to a third generation you can use in standard industrial C-mount camera lenses up to 7 megapixels. On the other hand, there was another features which you got it. Compared to second generation, you had higher dynamic range. Yeah, so it helps for some type of applications. And for the newest generation, which is available right now, and Matrix Vision, a brand of Balluff, can offer all of these sensors already, is a fourth generation of IMX sensors, which you can see the biggest difference is that pixel size is much smaller, 2.74 microns, which get you possibility to use C-mount, standard C-mount lenses up to 24 megapixels, which is impressive compared to, for example, third generation or first generation 7 megapixel or 2.4 megapixel camera or image sensor. And still, I'm missing one column, which I show you right now. It's, I would say, black. These three black panthers, and they're a bit different compared to the rest of the image sensors. They are rolling shutter cameras. I don't want to go too much details about the technology, but point is, if you have static, not really dynamic applications, so for example, in production line, you stop production and you need to make just picture, I would recommend to test these sensors as well, because compared to global shutter cameras, which are the rest of them, they are on half price and they are really, really a great, let's say, technology and technical specification which you can use it. So have a look on the chart right now. 5 years ago, you had only these few white dots here, but today you can see how many different image sensors you are able to use it in your applications. But don't be a bit confused. Yeah, I can show you that, for example, here is the camera which can make over 600 frames per second, but it doesn't mean that your interface, which camera is using, is capable to do that as well. So we are presenting here that a camera can do almost 700 frames per second, but for example, in USB 3, you are able to make a maximum 300-400, for example, frames per second, which is still quite a lot. But for some applications, high-speed applications, maybe it's not enough. So definitely, if you are confused and you have some specific application, feel free to contact us, and we will be happy to support you and help you with your needs and expectations. But okay, so right now you can see we have many different type of cameras available on the market, but how to decide the right one? For example, for 5 megapixel camera, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can choose easily 7 different cameras. So how to define which one is the best for you? And it's coming. It's up to you right now to find out actually what do you need. So you need to ask the questions to yourself. What do you expect from it? Are you going from CCD technology and you want right now to have new CMOS cameras? So do you want to have better specification, or you are really looking for some reduce the cost? Because compared to CCD, the technology with the same resolution, you typically will get the not so, let's say, inexpensive camera. So you will save even the money. But on the other hand, maybe you are providing the system on the market which that you want, that it's the best on the market. So you are looking for the best conditions, yeah, the best possibilities. But what does it mean for you? Is it high speed? Is it some sensor size? Is your applications light sensitive? And so there is really many options and many technical specifications which we need to find out, and we are happy to help you with it. So feel free to contact us, and we can get you the information and describe you which type of camera and image sensor you should look for. But okay, so right now, what actually made the industrial camera more intelligent? We can, let's say, increase the quality of the picture before we will send this picture or this data to your image processing brain. I discussed about the image processing and pre-processing brain a few minutes ago. So right now I would really touch directly what you can do it inside of the camera. before it will leave even this industrial camera. So you can make the more intelligent camera thanks to, I would say, two basic parts. You, if you want really more intelligent camera, you should check that the camera has possibilities or have the FPGA, which is a field programmable gate array, or easier, let's say, translation can be its integrated circuit, which is designed to be configured. And we, Matrix Vision, a brand of Balluff, is really doing these features, which means that you are able to make the camera more smart, and you can modify the picture before it's going to the host PC. And to do that, you need the second part, which is internal memory, or it can be called memory buffer, which can save additional pictures before it's sending out from the camera. And for example, one of the first pre-processing features which I can explain you here right now is that you can, for example, you have a conveyor belt and you are tracking your samples there, and you can, with this smart or industrial smarter, more intelligent camera, do to set pre or post trigger mode, which means that if the camera will get the trigger information from the sensor that we want to see these pictures, you can define even if you want to watch, observe the pictures which are even before this trigger. And it's thanks to this internal memory or image memory buffer, which means that camera typically is saving this information first to the internal memory. And if nothing happened, it will, the data will be thrown out. But if you needed these pictures and these data, then we can take it from this internal memory and send it to your host PC. And so this is first idea what you can get it from it. So you can use it as a pre and post trigger mode. But on the other hand, you can actually achieve also higher frame rate, so higher frequency. Just imagine you have gigi camera. So for 5 megapixel camera, or let's say the standard interface, gigi interface can make 120 megabytes per second. So if I will translate it to 5 megapixel camera, you can get, for example, 23 frames per second. But thanks to the FPGA and internal memory, we can save actually more pictures and much faster inside of the camera, and we can speed it up shortly up to 86 frames per second. So this is really great feature which you can use where you look for higher, let's say, frame rate, but you don't want to use more expensive, for example, interface. Yeah, of course you could use, for example, 10 gig interface, yeah, camera, but if you are able to use it, the smart feature, which is free of charge actually, then why not to use it, right? But let's have a look on more details for this pre-processing functions and features. I have to say we have many different features which are available free of charge inside of our cameras, and I'm not able to explain you here all of the functions which we have, but what I can do for you is that I will get you some small bonus. Just link with me on LinkedIn and send me just a small message, connect with me and tell me, hey, please send me the pre-processing features, or send me this catalog or document. I prepared, prepared 110 pages documents where we are explaining lots of these pre-processing functions and what you can do it with it. And so just connect with me, and I'll be happy to share it with you after presentations. But okay, so what everything you can get it from these pre-processing features. It will optimize actually your image quality. It will simplify the hardware and even cabling structure. It can increase, as I show you already before, the speed and image quality. And it can reduce really even a time to market installation of your application, software cost, hardware cost. So definitely there are lots of possibilities how you can combine and modify your systems to be more effective and will be used a much better way. I have, let's say, two, three different, let's say, features which I will share it with you to have imagination what you can actually expect from the camera. So first one, which is very popular in our cameras, is smart frame recall. This is the function which is called, and it will increase the speed of the camera. So imagine you have 31 megapixel camera, and in USB 3 interface, you can make roughly 12 frames per second. If you have a conveyor belt and you are looking for these codes, it's really hard to recognize it in 12 frames per second. So what you can do is that we inside of the camera will decrease the resolution of the picture, which means that we are sending just thumbnails which are going to the host PC, and these thumbnails are even going much faster. And so PC is waiting for the information, hey, I'm looking for some white part which could be actually this QR code, for example. And if the host PC will recognize, hey, I want to see it, this part of the picture in full resolution, because I want to read it, the code, then the host PC is sending information back to the camera, hey, I want to see just this area of interest, please send me it in full resolution. And then, because the camera is saving the pictures inside in frame buffer, then we know which picture the PC wants to see in full resolution, and camera can take it from the image memory and send it back in full resolution, or just area of interest can be sent it in full resolution. So this is the great application which can be used for such a feature to increase the speed, for example, of the camera. And what you will get it, for example, you need to use more cameras next to each other, which is detecting every part, and you are not able to check it the whole area of interest just by one camera. But with this function, you can do it. You can do it because we are able to sending just area of interest of this camera. Of course, there are another possibilities how you could solve it. You can, for example, take much, let's say, faster interface. It can be camera link, 10 gig interface camera. But why you should do that when it's five times more expensive, for example? Then you can just call this function inside of the camera, which is free of charge, and you will be able to use it. Another feature which I would like to also explain you is the line scan mode in area scan cameras, which means you have a line scan camera is the camera where is only one line of pixels. So you are detecting really a small part, and it's used in very high speed applications. For example, in printing machines, or you want to check, for example, the quality of the wood. And what we installed or what we developed was that we can decrease the area of interest to area scan camera up to only 16 lines, and we can speed up extremely the camera, even standard area scan camera, up to 60 kilohertz, which again will get you benefits to reduce your time to installing the camera, will reduce your hardware cost, even the software cost, because honestly, area scan camera and line scan camera has different, let's say, basic pricing. So this was only a few example of the smart features. There is another one, for example, you are able to connect directly the motorized lenses to our industrial cameras or even liquid lenses. And we have already prepared, for example, drivers. I would like to go in more details, but unfortunately, I don't have so much time, which I would like to share with you. But if you have some specific applications, again, come back to us and we can discuss about it after the presentation. What do you looking for? How you want to use the cameras? And we will be able to help you with it. But typically it's used, for example, in areas where you have, for example, different working distances and you need quick focus. So in typical solution can be, you have there two cameras with two different lenses, but why to install there two cameras? You will have again higher cost, let's say longer time to integrate the camera and lenses when you can have only one system which can do the both. So we spoke until now about the software, and I would like to touch right now also the hardware part of the cameras, because there are not only possibilities of one interface, or there is not only one filter which can be inside of the camera. There is many possibilities which you can use it. For example, in our way of thinking, we have really flexible kit which you can use it. So you define first, for example, your interface or board, let's say camera modules which you want to use it, which means let's say, for example, if I will stay only in Ethernet gigi cameras, which are mainly used in factory automation, for example, and they are very well known, then you have options, for example, like RJ45 connectors, but you can use also M12 connectors, which are even IP67. So as you can see, even the standard camera, it can be immediately IP67. So you don't need to care about the harsh environment if you have. Then it depends, for example, which type of lightning or application do you use. We can put it inside of the camera, in front of the image sensor, directly the proper filter. It can be IR cut filter, daylight cut filter, only glass, for example, or special bandpass filter. So if you have any laser applications, you can have already integrated filter which you need, and you don't need to look for another one, which you would put it typically in front of the lens. And when we discuss about IP67, actually we have even available IP67 type of lenses, but if you have just standard a lens, you can use a cover, which is which cover actually the or enclosure which cover the lens. But there are another options which you can have if you have really huge different temperatures for your application, from minus 40 Fahrenheit up to 150 Fahrenheit. We have even the camera module or camera type, which is doable for such applications. Or do you want to connect directly with PLC? then you would choose the level which is possible to connect directly to PLC. So again, you don't need any other hardware which will transfer the information from the camera to PLC. So this was the house version of cameras, but if you want really purely integrate the camera to your system, then you can also order only board level cameras. And it's again the similar. You will just define which type of interface you are using. Is it micro B, USB micro B? Is it type of C version? Or even would you like to have just a connector, Molex connector, 48 pin connector, and you want to connect directly to your host PC, feel free to order it as you need it. Then you would describe which type of image sensor do you want to have it. And then we can find out the proper lens holder. So for smaller image sensors, maybe F-mount type of holder would be enough. On the other hand, for big cameras, we can have options like C-mount or M42 holders. So there are again many variants, and you would be really surprised how many different types of cameras you could have. So I'm curious if you'll be interested to hear it, just touch with me or let me know what do you think, how many type of cameras we have. And if it's still not enough, it means that you have really, really difficult application on space, for example, or your needs are really much, much further, just try to touch with us, because we are really specialist in OEM type of cameras. We can really bring you a different view on the whole camera system, and maybe we can help you to solve the applications from the way which you would not even expect it. So here is only a few examples which how we modify the camera for our customers. And there can be really different type of filters. We can modify even housing, make different size of housing. Yeah? Even connectors can be completely different than what is our standard. Do you need to freeze even the software or firmware? Just feel free to connect with us, and we could bring you some new ideas on your technology and system. So how I would like to summarize today's presentation. I would like to get you just few takeaway messages from it. And it's just don't scare to use preprocessing functions and features and brain before it's going to image processing library. It can get you really much better the quality and can even reduce the cost, R&D and time to market. Please forget on CCD cameras for industrial machine vision. Yeah, there are still some markets where CCD are used very well, for example, astronomy, but for machine vision and factory automation, CMOS right now is only the way how you should use the cameras. And maybe the most important one would be just discuss with your machine vision vendor how to optimize your system. There are many ways. It's not just you don't need, let's say, just to buy the camera and to expect that you will get the picture from the camera. You can get it much more. So feel free to touch with us about that. And it can really reduce the number of components which you are using in your applications. So Really, thank you for your time and your attention. Feel free to connect with me. I will be also in this platform, definitely at least next 1 hour, so you can reach me directly and we can discuss your applications, your questions, your needs. And yeah, thank you very much. This was it.
Thanks, Frank. Thank you very much. And I'm gonna take control here.
Mm-hmm. So do we have questions there? Because honestly, I was not able to check it, the question.
Yes, yes, Frank, we had a couple of questions. Mm-hmm. Let's see, the first one here we have from Dave, and he's saying, what's the most common interface used today with industrial cameras?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is great. Yeah, this is a great question. I would say when the Dave is from factory automation world, definitely I would recommend it and use Gigi cameras, Gigi interface. If we are going to more, I would say, integration of the camera to the whole system, then all USB is very strong. But factory automation, Gigi interface is, I would say, the most used camera platform.
All right. Then we had somebody asking about the replay. Just for everybody, there will be a replay available on the platform of this. But then we just had somebody asking, because Frank, you mentioned the IP67 version of the camera, would it hold up in a welding environment?
Oh, okay. Yeah, this is very hard question, I have to say, because what does it mean, this welding environment? Is it some temperature difficulty? It depends also about the welding itself and how far the camera is the process. So if you have, Craig, a really specific application, just touch with me directly and we can discuss about it, because we can think also about different type of lenses which could be used. And we can think, if it would be possible in your application, that camera doesn't need to be very close to the welding, but it can be farther, and then the environment would be really, really enough to solve IP67. Yeah. So I would say in general, yes, but it depends about the specification or application itself.
All right. Thank you, Frank. And it looks like those are all the questions that we have. So if anybody has any other questions, like Frank said, we will have he will be stationed in the virtual platform today for the next hour or so. So you can reach out to him with your specific applications and find out which cameras would be best. So if you have any other questions, please use the group chat feature on the platform. Reach out to our other experts. Like I said, Frank will be there for the next hour or so. But also, if you're watching this in the future or you would like to connect with Frank on LinkedIn, here's his information. We also have his email address there. So if you, again, have any questions for our presenter that you would like to hook up with him afterwards, please use those links there. Also, check out our demos and the different exhibits in the virtual platform. We will have staff on hand all week. So please explore that room there. Thank you for your attention. Thank you, Frank, for taking the time and giving this presentation. I just want to say thank you again to everybody and make sure to connect with us and let us know how we can help you be prepared for 2021. I'm gonna leave everyone with the remaining presentation schedule for the rest of the week. Please check out the rest of our live presentations and use the platform there to access them just like you did here. But thank you all for joining us. Have a great day.